The first step is painting the area where you are going to do it. Baba ji, थोड़ा सा साफ कर रहे हैं बस आराम से लेके. So just preparing the area, first step. So it's better than. So whenever you are doing prostate biopsy, the first step is you need to do digital examination by yourself. Here is a 72-year-old male who presented with raised PSA and lower urinary tract symptoms. So on MRI, we found that in the right peripheral zone, there is a suspicious area. So first step is you need to do DRE yourself and then understand whether that suspicious area, are you able to feel it on DRE. So the suspicious area is actually, I am just trying to feel it, but on DRE I feel that everything is looking benign to me. I didn't feel exactly any hard area per se, but definitely on MRI there is a suspicious area. So that is not felt here. After I have done a DRE, so just cover the area. Okay. Cover the area and then prepare the site for like this. So initially when you are taking the probe, first it is recommended to clean the probe with sterilium. So my assistant is handing over me the truss guided probe. So we are first cleaning it with sterilium. Okay. So when you clean it, can completely clean this area with sterilium. And also the length cable. Cable also you need to clean it for some length. After you clean the probe with sterilium, so first thing is you need to take the jelly. This is the condom. So put some jelly inside. So that's it, enough. So after putting the jelly, just cover the probe with the condom. So this is important step. Okay. After you have done this, once this is done, so I have covered it up to this area. Now you take the connector. So this is the attachment which is there for doing biopsy. So let us do one by one, no problem. So first thing is we'll be keeping it like this, okay. So after it is attached, you should click it out so that now it is fixed. Now you take the puncture needle guide. Sorry. Yeah. So now you have connected it. So this is how it is done. Then after this is done, you will take the next condom and you will cover it up again over this. Okay. Jelly. This is the main ultrasound jelly which we routinely use it, and then we'll keep it cover on. Okay, so this is done. So when once this is done, you are ready. Now the entire system is ready. So now you should start. First, always try to do a baseline ultrasound yourself. Okay, then we'll plan the biopsy. So I am first doing a basic ultrasound first. So take the probe. बाबा जी बस एक छोटा सा अभी टेस्ट शुरू हो रहा है. आराम से डेला छोड़ के मुंह खोल के सांस लो. बस बहुत अच्छा, गुड. सो वी हैव स्टार्टेड विथ ए ट्रस नाउ इनिशियली. सो यू कैन सी आई हैव पुट माय प्रोब इनसाइड. सो दैट्स द ब्लैडर, यू कैन सी देयर. एंड देन दिस इज द एक्सियल व्यू एंड दिस इज द सैजिटल व्यू. So in both the views we are assessing the prostate. So I have gone inside the bladder first. So you can see both the seminal vesicles, this area. Okay, those are the long elongated seminal vesicles there. Okay, these are the seminal vesicles on both sides. So this is the right side of the patient and that side is the left side. So when I am coming down, you can see now that's the base of the prostate. Okay, so I am coming down. You can see some amount of calcifications which are nothing but corpora amelia, which are seen generally at the junction of the peripheral zone and the transitional zone. Okay, so those some few calcifications are seen there. When I'm coming down, so now you can clearly see the peripheral zone. This is the peripheral zone. So there is one suspicious area which they have mentioned in the MRI. However, on DRE I didn't feel anything abnormal. So I'm coming down. So that's how I came out. Okay, so now you see it on this side, on the right side. So I am turning my probe onto the right side. I am just scanning it area whether there is any suspicious area or not we are assessing. So you see, this is the center part is the urethra. Okay, I have turned it on the right side and now I am seeing this peripheral zone. Okay, okay, okay. So I didn't feel any much of abnormality over here. So go inside, go inside, go inside. So we will be doing a conventional truss then, a biopsy. And that's the entire scanning of the thing. So when you reach the apex, you see the urethra dot like thing in the urethra. Okay, so this is the basic scan which I have done. Started?
Sure.
So in the sagittal view, you can see this is the bladder and this is the prostate which you are seeing. So I am coming back, you can see clearly there, see this?
Neck.
This is somewhere, this is the neck of the bladder somewhere here. So you can see this entire benign prostatic enlargement of the prostate which is seen here. So you can see, you can come out slowly, okay? If the patient is catheterized, you can clearly see the catheter also. So I am scanning all around. You can see the junction, this calcification again, which we have seen there. This calcification is seen here at the junction of the benign nodule and the peripheral zone. Okay, peripheral zone is below. Okay, so that we are seeing here. So I didn't see any suspicious area there. See, see the calcification there? Okay, that's the calcification there. So that's entire benign nodule like thing. So I couldn't find any suspicious area to me in the truss also. Okay, this is the 18 gauge prostate biopsy gun, which is marketed by Bard. So you need to take it. You need to press both these two things here. So this is a guard which is kept there. So you take it out. And now this is the gun. So before doing the study, you need to press both the ends like this. So when you go inside, the moment you press this backside button, it will fire. So this is this much distance it will fire. Okay, so you can see here nicely. So this is the area which is there in the biopsy gun where your prostatic core will come here. So it is roughly around 2 to 2.5 centimeter would be the distance of this one. So you need to, before doing firing it, you need to press both the buttons, and then when once you go to the desired side, just press this one. Okay, if you just do only once, it will not fire. See, it will not fire, it will not fire. So always you need to press both the things, then only both will go back, and then when we'll fire it, it will go. Okay, that's how it is to be done. So first load this like this and then go to the site of biopsy and then do it. So when once you position it nicely, first go to the base of the bladder. So when once you are at the desired location, when once you keep the desired location, you can pass the probe like this, keep it inside, and then you can fire. Okay, that's how you do it. Before starting the procedure, there is one area which we can press it also. This is the puncture guide button. So you can show on the screen now. Show on the screen. When we press this button, now press the button. You can see that guide comes out. This line will come. So this will show where your needle is going while you are doing biopsy. Okay. Now show this area. So when you are doing the biopsy, so position it like this. Keep it in the desired position and you will be passing it like this. Okay. And then do a biopsy. I always say when once you do this, when you take the core, I always keep my one assistant with me. So the core which I have taken, I will put it on to his arm here, so that he can, by using a needle, he will take that core and then he'll put it in the specified bottle. So that's how we do it. Ready? So what I do, I first go to the base of the bladder. See, now I have gone to the base of the bladder. I'm coming out. So now you can see the prostate nicely. So this is the base of the bladder. So first thing is, I am rotating my probe onto the right side. I said on the screen that left side is the left side on the screen would be the right for the patient. So I am just rotating the probe. Now this is the area which I want to take first biopsy. See, you can see my needle down there. This is a track. So always try to, if you hold it like this, it is very difficult for you to pass the needle. So what I suggest, it's better to hold it like this. So this is the way you can hold it for easily doing the biopsy. So now you see I am passing it. Okay, so on the screen I have gone into the bladder, I have come out, so I am rotating it, now I am keeping it. So there are two ways to pass. One thing is, you can pass it like this or you can pass it like this, but I always prefer to do it like this. Why? Because when you fire it, both these two things will come out. So when you are doing it like this, sometimes they might hit onto the probe, so it will be difficult. So always keep it onto your side and then go inside. Okay, now this will go easily there. See, keep it there. Now see, go to the screen, now you can see the movement on the screen, see, this is the side which is moving. Go close, you can see, the movement onto the scheme. So I just see that movement there in the base of the prostate, I am firing. One, see the needle there down, how it is coming out. Okay. So when once I bring it out, just show it to him, I just pull out this one and just give the core onto him. See, that's the core. So this is very easy now. Now put it on the bottle there. Using a needle, he will take the biopsy core slowly and he will put it in the specified bottle. So that is number one. Now coming onto the medial part. Now we have rotated it medially. Okay. See, initially we have taken laterally. Now we are coming medially. At the same side, I have come a little bit medially. Now same thing. I am pressing both these two. Okay. No problem. I have pressed both of these things. I am keeping it again. The same position. Go there. See the movement on the prostate there. Slightly. And now we are firing. See, below base needle. The needle is coming out. Okay. Second one. Okay. Now let's go on to the opposite side. So in the same area, I have gone into the other area now. So I am again passing it there. See, I am keeping it there. See, so there you see the movement. Go close, just show that movement. Upar, dot ke pass. See that movement? Yeah. Now come back. Now go to that lower screen. Now just focus on that area. I am just firing. See the needle there. Okay? The needle is coming out. Okay? So when once we have done the base part, I am just coming out slightly. So you can just see in the screen, focus this area. So after you have done the base biopsy, now I am pulling the probe out. You see, the prostate is moving down now. So now I have come to the middle part. Okay, at this part again I go laterally. I will take a biopsy here because that's the suspicious area which they are telling on MRI. So I am taking biopsy, you can see my needle there. And I am firing. See? Yes, we are again taking that. A little bit come back. Yeah. After we have done the mid zone of the prostate, I am coming back again. You see? I am coming back again. Now you can see here nicely. This is the peripheral zone here. This is almost we are reaching the apex. So here we need to take the biopsy. There is one suspicious area which was there on the right side. So we are targeting that. So I kept it at that location. So we are taking the apical biopsy now. Okay? So I am taking the apical biopsy. One. Come on. So at the end actually we found that there is one suspicious area which they have mentioned. Probably this area. You can see this area there is some suspicious area here. So we are taking two additional biopsies at this location. Okay. So I have kept it there. The dot is there. And now I am passing it. See the movement there on the screen. Then that's it. You can just take it out. Okay. Take out the probe gently. Now I'll hand it out to my assistant. First clean the area. Okay. Clean the area. Put in some glass. Okay. Put some jelly over it. So the jelly is applied over it. And this can be kept inside the rectum for some time. Okay. You can press that inside. So you can keep a little bit outside it so that the patient can be told to remove it after some time. Okay, so this is done. So that's how you finish the procedure. Okay.